Hi, and thanks for logging on to the Daily Dvar. And here's a brand new halacha for you. And it's for Wednesday, the 6th day of July. Here we go. You know that whenever a chasan and kala, a bride and groom, get married, for the next 7 days, we have special meals wherever we can gather 10 men or more together at a meal. Then sheva brachos are recited. Seven special blessings are recited because there's a minyan there and it's a festive seuda, a festive meal, the chasan and kala there. And therefore, at the end of the meal, seven special extra blessings are recited, and they're called the Sheva Brachos. Now, what you might not know, and please always try to have this arranged, is that you're only eligible for saying the Sheva Brachos if there are 10 men are there at the meal, and at least one of them is Panim Chadashos, which means a new face, someone who's brought an added simcha to that evening, an added happiness to that evening, because he wasn't at the wedding or no one's seen him yet, and when he comes in, it's like, oh, a new person is here. You must have a Panim Chadashos, some say two new people, but some rabbis are lenient and say that it's okay to have at least one new person there at the meal, and then you are then and only then are you eligible to say the seven extra blessings at that festive meal. On Shabbos or Yom Tov, at the first meal of Shabbos and the second meal of Shabbos, and so too with Yom Tov, at the first meal, you know, the Friday night one, the night meal or the lunch meal, those are eligible for Sheva Brachos without Panim Chadashos, because the great addition of Shabbos or Yom Tov being there is enough to add that newness to the occasion. And so on Shabbos, for the first two meals of Shabbos, you don't need to have a new face there because Shabbos is the Panim Chadashos. Now at the third meal of Shabbos, the Shalosh Seudos, there it's debated. Some say that it's better to have a Panim Chadashos at the meal, at the Shalosh Seudos, at the third meal. And others say that if you can't get a Panim Chadashos, a new face to that third meal, you could still get by at least having a formal Dvar Torah from the Chassan himself. That too adds to the specialness of the Simcha. So at the third meal of Shabbos doesn't quite act as the newness anymore, but a great special Dvar Torah from the Chassan would act as a newness also. If you can't get the Chassan to say a big special Dvar Torah at that Shalosh Seudos, then a big special Dvar Torah from somebody else at the meal could suffice, even if you don't have a Panim Chadashos there. The main point is that something new has to happen at that third meal, a great Dvar Torah from the Chassan, or at least a great Dvar Torah from somebody else at the meal, and then you wouldn't need a Panim Chadashos at the third meal of Shabbos. Bottom line, always try to have a Panim Chadashos at the Sheva Brachos meals. For sure, it won't be necessary at the first two meals of Shabbos, and it's kind of necessary, or at least have a very special Dvar Torah from the Chassan or a special guest at the Shalosh Seudos meal. Otherwise, if these things aren't fulfilled, then you're not really eligible for the Sheva Brachos. Now, if you ever get into an in-between situation, certainly ask a competent rabbi what to do. I'm just educating you now as to the matter, and now you know how to ask more educated questions. Thanks for logging on. Log on again tomorrow for more. Bye-bye.